change, you know, the general image that people have had of the Federal University of Petroleum Resources, EFRON. One of the projects is the electrification project of the university. The other project is the accommodation project for the students. We have two hostels that are coming up. Another project is the academic staff building. One is completed, one is in progress. And then one of our key projects is the health center for the students, which is also completed and is currently just being used. Coincidentally, no project in this university has ever been commissioned, and we are hoping that maybe we will take a sample of one project that the Honorable Minister may commission for the university. With the Suwajin side, if we can move straight, you know, to the health center, then we go through the right and look at it. Thank you.
Just two projects that you can see. You can't go to all the projects.
Okay, the health center, and this is academic staff building that is currently being used as an administrative building. We have all the offices for the acting vice chancellor, the registrar, the bursar, and other administrative staff.
What one structure you want to see?
The health center.
Not the academic structures?
No, sir, because the major academic structure that is nearest to us is still under construction. We haven't completed it. It's just behind us, sir. Okay, we might want to see that. Thank you, sir. Third floor, the second floor, is where the main administration will be. The bottom two floors will be where academic staff will have offices, professorial offices, etc. It's funded by the TED Fund, and is currently, we have 3 months outstanding time for it to be completed. That structure, sir, is the first phase of the College of Sciences. It is currently containing both the two Colleges of Science and College of Technology. 2011 and occupied 2011-2012. On the left, we have the two hostels for female and males. The one on the right hand side is 95-98% completed, should be useful. Unfortunately, sir, because of the land, sir, the foundation for the first one actually is enough to carry about 3-story building, but they have to scale it down.
Okay, Honourable Minister, this is the complex at ESAT now.
ESAT now is housing all the academic activities in terms of the administrative aspects of Colleges of Science and Technology. In the College of Science, we have 5 departments and 5 programs. In the College of Technology, we have a similar number of programs. We have 2 deans. Dean of Technology is here, who will quickly... Professor Damisa. Okay. And Professor Adepo Ju is the Dean of College of Science. This place basically has all the offices, like I said, for the staff, a lecture theater, and some few laboratories. The other laboratories are located in the buildings that we left behind. So if we can just quickly go through this side, we'll be able to see what is available. ₦500 million since 2007, because it wasn't forthcoming. We came in as a interim team to provide management for the university in the last 10 months when the tenure of the Vice Chancellor, Professor Alabi, and the former Registrar expired. In the absence of counsel, Mr. President appointed us as acting management pending the outcome of the white paper on the university and the establishment of a council, which will now through due process appoint a Vice Chancellor. So what we have been doing is to manage the university, get it back on track, and provide it with what is required, demonstrations. On our coming, we managed to do accreditation, we managed to get the first set of students to graduate, and the second set are graduating from today. That is for sciences. Technology started 2 years later.
So they are not due for graduation until 2014. So meanwhile, what we are doing is putting together what will be required for their accreditation and their graduation before that period of time comes. If a council comes in tomorrow, it sets up, gets the white paper from government, implements it, and even the issue of it's not we that are, so we, that's what we inherited. Now we have made arrangements, like I said, in fact yesterday we received the letter permitting the university to draw down on all the funds from 2008 to 2011. And in fact, when the Honourable Minister was just coming in, we were sitting with the Dean of Technology, the Head of Electrical Engineering, Mechanical Engineering, etc., and looking at what the consultants have submitted as the priority list for equipment for the College of Technology. Because that is the next college that is in line.
We are worried because it's a pioneer university of petroleum technology, I mean petroleum resources, and we expect the lab to be well, stocked with equipment. Been to new universities that were set up last year, and we have seen that their labs are up to date. The universities that are picking up this year, I've seen their labs are up to date. We went to Abakiliki, we saw the University of Ebonyi, we went to Nasarawa, we went to which other state?
Otoke.
Huh? Bayelsa. And we saw well-equipped laboratories. So this should not be different.
Yes. Honorable Minister, prior to March 2012, I'm the de facto director of academic standards at the National Universities Commission. I was sent here on a salvage mission because this university failed to perform. But not only did the university fail to perform, in all honesty, this university funding has been, because I'm aware of the setting up of the 9 new universities because I participated in that and all their funding programming. This university has never had that opportunity. So even with the best intention in the world, you've seen the road coming into this university, sir. It's a state road that for the last 5 years, every year it is on the budget, but it has never been done. The same thing, nobody, not one PTDF refused to give a penny to this university. The Delta State government has never given a penny to this university. No organization, in fact, if you look at my office, I have banned all calendars from any company, because no company that has been benefiting from the oil of Nigeria has ever given anything to this university. So it has been the federal government normal allocation to the university system that has been coming to this university. For 2012, we're supposed to get 600 million naira. The money was paid into the central bank in the name of College of Petroleum and Gas Engineering, which was the precursor of this university. The university couldn't access it. By August, December, the name was changed. University went for the money. It had been mopped up, and it was only 300 million. So this university has been facing a lot of problems. And our hope had been that, sir, government should realize that this is the only one of its kind in Africa. And let's face it, we know what happens. Other countries tomorrow may open a university. And we know Nigerians in their typical diaspora attitude. Before you know it, the few lecturers will depart. Honorable Minister, I want to seize this opportunity to say the comments you have made are very true, but this university, being a specialized university, requires specialized funding. Whoever is leading this university, the only way it can move forward is if it has what is required. We are competing with PTI for lecturers. They are teaching diploma, we are teaching degree programs here. But people prefer to go there because they get 10 times the salary you get paid here. Nobody wants to come here. So, Honorable Minister, I agree with you 100%. Bayelsa, the new university in Keshere, the new university in Dusima, the new university in Taraba, they will be better than this university because the funding they have gotten is better, sir.
But let me say this. This can only be maybe a result of the protracted management crisis. It can be because government doesn't have money to fund this university. You have just said now that your funds since 2008 are still tied down. So it's not, that is not to say there is no money to develop this university. I think there are internal problems. And if you cannot access even your third funding, it can be government. It can be that the money is there. We're not accessing it. We've been to university, third projects are the main driving force now of all the tertiary institutions. And this is 2013. So if for 5 years we are yet to access your funding, you can just imagine the kind of crisis that would have, that is resulting now in the world. That's what we're saying now. So what you say, you're a rescue team. You know? So I hope that we'll be able to address the problems quickly, because in setting up this university, government's intention is that Nigeria, being an oil and gas destination in this continent, should be the pioneer in developing the kind of high-level manpower that will domesticate the oil industry and ensure that we participate at the highest level. And so we have seen, that's why we're here, also on pathfinding, to see those things that are working, those things that are not working. Like I said, we've been to new universities that are less than 1 year old, and we have seen well-established laboratories, well-established classes, well-established ICT services, online libraries already in the 9 new universities that were established in 2011. So we have no reason not to have this university working at higher level. And also, oil and gas is a very rich industry. So we must have contributions, PTDF, oil companies, and so on. But you see, you have to develop programs that will attract them. Listen, no oil company will just bring money because you have the University of Petroleum Resources. No. It is the programs of the university that will announce you, that will make you attractive, that will make you be irresistible in terms of funding. You know, so, like I'm saying, I understand the crisis that have bedeviled the management of the university. And now that you are here, your duty as a leader is to ensure that you come up with appropriate recommendations by your team, even as we await the white paper that will enable the university to access existing funds that are sitting there, which you have not been able to access. Yes, so yesterday now, it's still the letter. The money has not come here. Sorry. You have just said the letter asking you to access this yesterday. So practically the money is still out there.
It took 3 months to follow the due process.
That is what I'm saying.
And what I have managed to reach that level where you are now actually giving them.
Well, that's where you are. You're on your marks. Your money hasn't come yet. So. That's the truth. It's still in the vault of third funds. So which means that for 5 years, those even some of the new things we saw in the new university are third projects. But third fund is the one that we took them away from basic education so that they can concentrate on higher institutions, tertiary institutions. I think you need to quickly gather yourself together and see what you can do to access these funds. But we don't want the situation where the quality of graduates will be affected, for example, by lack of facilities. So that will not be good for these young people. So we have seen it. It has a great future, but a lot will depend on the management and the vision for the university. Thank you very much.